What's going on, Rushers? Welcome back to Stage Rush TV, and this week I am joined by Sarah Roberts from the blog The Adventures in the Endless Pursuit of Entertainment. How are you doing, Sarah?
I'm good. A little hot.
On this cool, what do you mean hot? It's cool and brisk out today. You have to think opposite in these times, don't you think?
Yeah.
So Sarah is joining us this week. She was so intrigued by last week's episode with Kevin Daly from the Theater Aficionado at Large. And you know, we talked about the Kate Baldwin event last week, and you accompanied Kevin to that event.
Yes.
Well, what was it like? I mean, we were also excited hearing about it beforehand. How did it all go?
Oh, it was fabulous. Kate looked amazing. She's had her baby. He's about 3 months old now. It was an abbreviated concert, just a few highlights from the CD, which was recorded live at Feinstein's last March, which they did a concert, a succession over 7 nights. It's all Sheldon Harnick music. Well, he wrote the lyrics, and it's a compilation with other composers. Mm-hmm. A lot of... it's just really
So gems. She basically sang songs from that...
Yeah.
On that CD, yeah. And he was there. Was he sitting on stage like Kevin said
last week? Yeah, he actually got on stage with her, and they sang a couple together. And
that's nice.
He is just absolutely charming. Mm. He's wonderful.
So was there mingling at this part?
There was. After the concert part, we all kind of like went back to the green room at Feinstein's.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
And there was champagne, and they signed their CDs and copies of.
Cool. So who'd you talk to?
Mingled. I talked to her director, Diana Bajmiani. That's screwed up. I can't say her
Bajmiani. We'll just go with that.
Yes. And I talked to Kate and a few other people I knew.
Yeah.
And I got to meet Mr. Harnick.
Yeah.
He's lovely.
What did he say to you? What did you ask him?
I don't think I asked him anything. I was just happy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He seems like a cute older man.
Yeah. You know? He's awesome.
Yeah. Well, that sounds like a great night. I had, you know, a good day today. Of course, once again, I'm coming from as you can tell because I'm sweaty, I'm of course coming from the Broadway and Bryant Park concert, where they had their third week of the concert series. It was pretty good today, as I kind of felt it was not as good as last week. Last week was like an incredible week.
It was longer though, right?
It was longer this week because they fit 5 musical acts into today. It was Memphis and Billy Elliot and the Addams Family, the vocal people, polka people, and Rock of Ages. That was a lot. So Memphis came on, you know, Memphis was really good, and I'm actually not the biggest fan of the show, but Bryan Fenkart, who is the understudy for Huey, who is also a previous Stage Rush interview for the series, the Understudy Hall series, he was on, as he often is, for Chad Kimball as Huey, and he was so good, and this was actually my first time seeing him perform, and I was really glad. He really was great. He did Music of My Soul really good. And it was actually the understudies were on today from Memphis. It was Danielle Williamson along with him. They did a great job.
See, I was lost until I found. I was deaf until I heard. I'll make this world come around to the music of my soul.
Great job. Billy Elliot, it seemed kind of dull today for, you know, which a show that has pretty exciting numbers. It just seemed kind of dull to
what
me.
What number did they do?
Well, they started out with Electricity. And it did seem a little dull, however, really at the end though, when he does, you know, when the Billy character does like the pirouettes and the spins at the end, that really, he did it really good, and it did, you know, give me chills. So even at the end of a kind of a dull performance of the song, it was still really good. Addams Family actually was the one that seemed kind of sharp and new today. The energy was just really high. Of course, there was no Brooke Shields, as I predicted last week, but Rachel Potter was there, who is the new replacement Wednesday, and she was really good. She did her solo pulled, and she was really good. She's got an incredibly strong voice. And then there was the Voca people, which is like this cross between Blue Man Group and an a cappella group. It's really a cappella.
Right.
And it's really weird.
Voca, voca, ye.
I mean, they have some great vocals, some smooth choreography, but it's kind of a weird package. I don't know, I just thought it was very strange. And they brought a volunteer up on the stage. This woman, I mean, they just brought this woman up to serenade her. And she kind of looked like she wanted to crawl away, or melt away, rather, in shame. It was
so awkward.
A little awkward. Yeah. So looking forward to next week again. It's great, but you know, we all melted out there today. Now, last week we talked a lot about, we were talking more about Follies coming to Broadway. And I know that you, now we hadn't seen it yet and we're kind of anticipating how it's going to be. But you can give us a little sneak preview because you have traveled to the Kennedy Center a couple times. Just a couple times. Tell us about that.
I made 2 weekends out of it, not in a row. I saw it earlier in the run and then I saw it the final weekend with a different friend. And both times I saw tons of people I knew from New York there and all over the place. It's a big, beautiful Broadway show.
Yeah.
The music is thrilling. It's,
I'm excited because I have never seen it. I mean, some people are just excited for the production. I'm excited for the show in general because
I want to. Yeah, it's so interesting.
You know, I'm trying to collect all my Sondheims. Yeah. And collect them all.
Right. I think it's the most adult of Sondheim shows. Even with Sweeney, I think it's even more adult. It's just, it's about grown-ups and kind of expectations and dreams and where you go with your, your life. And, it's interesting.
Now, how many times did you see it at the Kennedy Center?
Five times.
That's a and because you have to travel to that.
If I'm going, I'm going
to
go.
So here's my big question. I like that. I like that commitment. So now, and it's coming to Broadway.
Yeah.
Are you going to see it on Broadway? Or are you?
Obviously.
Yeah. So you still haven't had enough. Well, that's a good sign.
Yeah. No, I haven't had enough.
That's a good sign.
Yeah. I mean, there are moments in it that I could hit the rerun button and just watch it over and over and over.
Well, I'm excited for that. Now, one thing that I know about you, Sarah, that I think is very interesting. You know, your love for theater, you will travel to theater. Mm-hmm. You know, the theater doesn't have to come to you, you will go to it. Tell us some about, like, what are some of the best traveling experiences you've had to go to when you're traveling to the theater? Because I pretty much stay around here, Broadway.
Right. Chicago for Patty's Gypsy at Ravinia. I went to London, I've been to London. I saw Harriet Walter and Beware Women, Women Beware Women at the National Theater. Subsequently, at that trip, I also saw Kate Baldwin in that very horrible show that they did.
What was it called? Paradise Found? Paradise Lost? Found or Lost?
Paradise Found.
Found. It was found. Or did
Paradise
they lose it?
Paradise Never Again.
They should lose it. Lose
all
Paradise
of the performers
found.
Were amazing, of course. It's just a crappy show.
Yeah. And didn't you say, you were telling me recently you went to Paris for Sweeney Todd, a version of Sweeney Todd?
Yes, I built my whole trip around it. When I heard that they were doing Sweeney at the Châtelet du Palmy, I said, I've got to be there.
Yeah.
I've got to see it. I don't know who's in it. Whatever, I don't care because I love the Broadway revival production that they did so much in 2005. I said, I have to go.
Yeah.
And I was not disappointed in the least.
That's great.
Yeah, it was amazing.
I think it's really cool that you build these trips around these shows. I mean, I think that's great. You know, the farthest I've really, I mean, of course, I've seen some London shows, but I would be lying if I said those trips were built around around those shows. But the farthest I travel, I mean, once a year I travel to Poughkeepsie to go to the Vassar Powerhouse.
It's a great
usually
trip.
It is great, and I go with friends, and we make a whole thing about it, which is great because then it becomes more. You know, the theater is like an experience, and so when you're even adding travel into it, it becomes even more of an experience. So that's what I do, but that's the extent of it. But I just think it's so cool that you're a traveler with theater.
Yeah, and I intend to continue to do that. I feel like I'm gonna go. I want to visit the city anyway. I need something to do at night. Might as well go to the theater. Why not build your trip around that? And it works out perfectly.
One that I want to know about. Give me the scoop on the Meunier Chocolate Factory.
Yeah.
Because that's so hot right now. So many productions have come there to Broadway. What's that one like? Because I have not
been there. Well, it's a great little theater. It's not that far from the Tate Modern. It's got a really great little restaurant attached to it, so you can go and have dinner there first, and then the theater itself is maybe 200 seats. It's pretty small, just sort of benches. They do have backs on them, semi-comfortable, and I've seen a couple things there now, and it's just a really great vibe. It's easy to see why people really
does it feel very there. Intimate it's intimate
it does yeah, yeah it's extremely well, intimate
I that's mean, one I would really like to go to
yeah it, I would highly recommend going to that theater.
I mean, personally,
I've been to West End once. What I saw was not that great. I think they don't have anything better than we do, maybe occasionally, but it's not going to be better than what you're going to get here on Broadway. So you might as well, if you want to see theater, go off you know, West End and see something, and it's a charming place.
Cool. Oh, and just going back to Follies, I just wanted to say that next week on Stage Rush TV, we might have a little bit of a Follies announcement, maybe in terms of a ticket giveaway, maybe. I don't know. I mean, I don't know. I really don't know yet.
And your co-host from the previous week is the instant winner.
Oh, by default, of course. So let's move on to some Broadway grosses now. Why don't you kick it off?
Hair, 56%.
Which doesn't surprise me. I mean, I know they probably got a big deal in that theater for the Hair tour coming back for Broadway for the Summer of Love, but that's a huge theater to fill, and
it's so
people
big.
Have seen it already. So anyway, I think that 56% was probably definitely the hardcore fans.
I think they were counting on tourists.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know. I'm not interested in the Hair. I don't get it.
And Jerusalem sold 65% of its ticket, which surprises me because now it's a summer crowd and they probably all heard that, you know, Mark Bryant's won the Tony. I'm surprised that it's not. I mean, I know it's almost done.
I don't think tourists, they just don't learn about plays. And if they're paying that much money for something, why see a play when you can see some big old Broadway musical?
For them, right.
You know, very exciting and, or at least fun.
Yeah.
I don't know. He's amazing. I haven't seen the play yet. I plan to before it closes.
Oh, so you're going to get in there
soon.
Yeah,
definitely. Yeah. I don't think I can miss him.
Right.
So I'm just a little bit slow.
No. Yeah.
This was not surprising, really, is it? Mamma Mia, 81%?
No, that doesn't surprise me. I mean, they could do a little better, but I mean, let's not split hairs here. But I mean, you know, they're getting the summer. Well, they're always at this. Mm-hmm. And the motherfucker with the hat closed out really strong, 101.3%, or a very successful run, one that started out in previews really shaky. So how awesome, I think it must feel great for them to have a really scary preview period and then to go on to, you know, a really good run with good reviews and end at 101.3%. So, Sarah Roberts from the Adventures in the Endless Pursuit of Entertainment, thank you so much for coming
on
this week.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for being on, and have a great week at the theater.
Okay.